Welcome back to Dead Boys Garage. Okay, now today, this is part two of the tow hitch of doom. These I showed you the other day, just welded these tabs on the bike over there and over there. And these are the connecting pieces for the tow hitch itself. So they are going to bolt kind of on there and then come aft at different angles to converge down at the back. Now, obviously, these being quarter plate, they are nice and strong. These holes, by the way, will be bigger. They're not big enough at the minute. They're only about 6mm, and I'm not going to bolt on a tow hitch with 6mm bolts. They're going to be 8mm. I'll just lob them out a bit later on, but just for now, I haven't got an 8mm drill bit that's sharp enough, so I'll just whack them through at that just for the purposes of test fitting and so on. Right, now, these have got to be welded into the tubage. Now it's this tube here, which I rescued from the old shop there. That's all the stainless tube, which I'm not going to use. I'm going to use this mild steel tube because I can weld it better. Purely because, I don't know, for some reason mild steel welds easier. And it's all going to get painted black anyway. So these tubes, what I've got to do is cut a slot. I've done one there. There's one I made earlier. And the idea is, this is two-handed, that these will then slot down inside there, like that, and will sit nicely in that slot and will get welded all the way down. And then, when they're on the bike, they will fit. Okay, they will fit on quite neatly. Like that, a little bit more out, so I'll measure them so that the correct amount is sticking out the top, and that will just get welded into the tube. Then I'll cap weld over the ends here, so that'll be a nice box section, nice strong piece, and then they'll just bolt neatly on there, and then one on the front and so on. So that is the task. First of all, just stick around, stay tuned, gotta cut some more of these, get them ready. Let's see if I can do it. See you in a minute. Right, simplest method. Bit of tape over it, use the doodad itself as a templature, draw down, and that should work. And obviously draw one on the other side that is level, so it's not cocked off to one side or twisted. That's all done. Now's the disc. Now I'm using one of these diamond discs because I found the simplest way. If you cut with, I did the first one, and on the first one, it's kind of wibbly wobbly because that's a standard cutting disc, which just kind of cut, made a bit of a mess. But with the diamond disc, rather neatly, you can come down one cut and then just nudge sideways with the disc, because on these diamond discs, they've got kind of diamond abrasion on the sides as well as on the edge. So you can kind of lean sideways into it and then just wear out the metal to the other side, so I can cut a neater, tidier slot, a tighter slot, ooh, a missus, with the diamond disc. So there's three done. Here goes the last one. Let's see how it goes.
Always put your Eltons on, but you know that. Final cut.
And here we are, all cutted. Now, the slot's a bit messy to look at now, but it's going to be welded anyway, and that just fits in there. Pucker. Pucker. Oh, pucker. Right. That now just needs a clean up. Fits in there just right. So let's give it a good clean up and see what they will look like.
Masking tape off. kind of welds itself on with the heat. So, gluey, gungy mess. There we go. Right, there's a little clean up. There's all four of them now. Now I'm going to get on the lapper of doom and lap all this chrome off, because you can't weld through chrome. So let's get them properly prepared for welding now. Get the brackets fitted in and start tacking them up. That is one. And there's four. There we go. All properly prepared. So we should now I'm going to grind down these shoulders just a little bit. Reason being, when these are in situ, they are completely level with the tube, and I want a little bit of recess for the weld to go in. This is thin tube, so I've got to be careful not to blow a lump out of it or blow holes in it, but I'm just going to grind these edges down a little bit. Also, that will take off any cack and give them a key as well. You know, this is all oily sort of engineering finish stuff you get from engineering shops. It's like an anodized finish or whatever, galvanized maybe. So I'm just going to grind that down anyway. So let's get a grinding wheel out and prep these. Okay. We are all ready for weldage. This is where it gets sparky. So what I've done with these having where which hole on the bike therefore marked on them, gonna obviously encase that in there, so just in case, just wrote on the tubes as well. Bit of forward thinking. Right, let's get this tacked on, see what it looks like. Oh, and I've just put roughly an inch and a half each one. Each one's going to have an inch and a half or inch and a quarter there sticking out the end to give it room to clear the bracket on the bike, so that'll look uniform, and then I can cap these in when they're done. Right, let's get cracking. Okay, that's all those welded in now. It's messy, as always with me. I'm not a brill welder, but that is strong. Everything went purpley blue, loads of penetration, and this sheet, which, well, tube, is about a mil and a half. This is 6 mil, so that difference meant that it was just blowing holes in it. But there it is, it's strong. Each of it has been beaten with a hammer, so it's nice and solid. All I'm gonna do now, just grind them down and then drill each one twice and bolt them through as well so that nothing comes off. Let's crack on with those. Okay, three centre punched.
we go. In the absence of a pillar drill, use what you have. Right, so those are pinholes now. As you can see with the welds, they are gross, but they're strong and thick, and I've left them proud. Yep, we could dress all that back and make it smooth, but then the brackets would fall out. So you're gonna leave a little bit of weld there proud, and they are not a problem because they're gonna get covered in seam sealer. I learned that trick from my mate Gary in Texas, building the awesomest Mustang ever. Seam seal the joints, and you won't get water in there, which will then cause problems. And I'm gonna put a seam sealer down inside there as well, because this is in an area just above the back wheel, so it's gonna get a lot of crap on it. Right, so hole drilled through. That's gonna find some bolts in the old bolt box of doom, and then bolt these four little babies together, give them extra strength. Okay, so let's have a rake, I think that one might do it. Only looking for that sort of thing. It's quite handy actually, put my end straight on it. Cool. Now what do we reckon? Oh, freaked myself out, I'm so lucky. Look at that, straight in there. I can assure you this is not predetermined. So that will bolt on there. So all I've got to do is have a rummage, find eight of those. Okay, let's have a scrape round, see what I've got. And there we are. That is about as strong as it needs to be, whoops, for the job in hand. What side's that? Off side rear. So, just giving it a quick offer up. That's then going to bolt through there and come aft where I can deal with the other end later on. But that is good enough for now. So as I just said, I'm going to get some seam sealer on this into the weld, get it protected from the weather, and get some gunge on the end of these threads. These are Loctited on and they're Nylock nuts, and I've ground them out and manged the threads up so they're not coming off ever. And that's about as strong as it needs to be because they're sharing whatever load. And when I put this on, I will test it by towing some old tyres up the road or something, something that pulls quite hard on them, just before I start bolting trailers to it. But here we go. That's the first half. That's the half that bolts to the bike. I've got to come back now and work out how to cut where and then how to build a plate, because on the back of the bike, there's going to have to be a plate on the rear. So these four are going to go aft and then bolt to or weld to or both a plate across the back. But that's cool for today. That's about 3-4 hours worth of fun. Messing around with scrap, really. It ain't serious. It's just a bit of fun. It's a rat bike. It's what it's all about. I'll probably seam seal that, paint it matte black, cover it up with gunge so that the weather never ever gets to it. But it is strong as you like. I beat it all to death with a hammer as I was welding it. So weld a bit, beat it, weld a bit, beat it again, making sure that it is strong. Proper penetration prevents piss poor welding. So we can keep this together. That's going to stay on the bike and it's not going to fall off down the road as I ride away. So let's get some sealer in it and see what it looks like. Right, there we have it. Now, that's enough for one day. So these are now been seam sealed. And I want to show you a little Doughboys Garage trick, tipette trick for the day. Instead of going out and buying expensive seam sealer, which is perfectly all right, and it's great if you're doing a cool project and you want it to be really cool, but this is a rat bike. I don't care, and I use what I have, you know me. So this, good old fashioned DIY No More Nails, that is the best welding panel seam sealer you can get. It is nothing more than a white glue bonding rubber. It sets by air dry, and all you do, spread it into the weld, and it sets rock hard. Takes overnight, still comes off up to half an hour later, but as you can see, just adds, it's like a glue, and this stuff sticks anything, and it does say on there metal, and it does work. I've used it loads of times. I've used it on the welds on the frame, use it on all the welding on this, just about every bit of welding I've done on this, I cover it in that No More Nails stuff, and this costs pennies. Just go to your DIY store and get it for next to nothing. You even get some for free. So there we go. Bit of No More Nails seam sealer. That'll have 24 hours to dry, and I'll just rub it down with some sandpaper and then coat it up with copious amounts of matte black. Good old fashioned blackboard special with a brush. Excellent. So there we go. That is it for now. That's about 4 or 5 hours darkness. This is the effect that we've got. This is the offside ones fitted. So effectively these bolts here, these bolts here will be up to 8mm shaft rather than sort of 5 or 6 at the minute. They're just there for the moment for location. So that is the effect. If I can just get out far enough. These are just way too long at the minute. I'll cut them at the right length when the time comes. Just want to get this end of the affair done first. Sort that out. So effectively these will be kind of bolted up there nice and tight, and then down around here where my hand is there'll be a frame across the back, and I don't know how that's going to work yet. I've got some sheet metal thick 6mm stuff on the bottom of those which I can lop off. Those are blind as well, these plates. There's no hole in the end of that, so if I cut that tube off, that plate is just a flat 6mm thick. What is it? It looks like about 4 or 5 inches by quarter inch thick, so that's going to be good and beefy. And I've got another one over there which I can use. So that stuff will be used, stainless welding to mild. Don't know what you welders think. I've done it loads of times. That there is stainless, that's mild steel. They're welded together, and I beat on that until the cows came home and it didn't come off. Just use stainless wire to weld it, that's all. So there we go, that's it for today. Looks messy and horrid, but once that's all black and painted, then that'll be absolutely fine. That is part two of the tow hitch. Obviously those two up there are for the other side. So effectively I've got the four legs going aft now, and the next part of the project is to work across what's going to go at the back to actually bolt the tow ball onto, that I can then drop a trailer on. So we shall see. There you go. Thanks for tuning in and watching Dillboy's Garage. This has been fun, I think. Take it easy, ride safe. I'll see you next time.